right, ladies and gentlemen, we are here and ready for our second round of 16s match of the day between Carla Munoz and Ronda Rejcic. I think the players are just about warmed up. Should be ready to go here in just a minute here from Sport and Health, Crystal City in Arlington, Virginia.
Thank you.
right, here we are, beginning of our second round of 16s match of the day between Ronda Rousey and Carla Munoz. We are live in Crystal City, Virginia at Sport and Health for the 24th annual NES Associates Christmas Classic Pro-Am. Sounds like a really long name for a tournament, but it is the one that we have. They can't. Score is one serving two here in game number one. I am joined by Rollout Racquetball's Jonathan Clay.
Thank you. Glad to be here. I'm assuming this is the very beginning of this first game?
It is, very beginning, 2-2 in game number one. Yes, very early here in game number one, 2-2, according to referee Monsi Mejia.
All right. On the court right next to us, we have Michelle Key taking on Veronica Sotomayor. Very interesting match, I think.
Yeah, I think that'll be a good match. Yep. I think this is actually going to be a good match. Carla's been playing some real good racquetball.
Yep.
Ronda always, you know, one of the top players in the world. I think this is going to be a good matchup, too.
Yeah.
Switch. All right, scores now 3 serving 2. Short serve called.
Just short. Barely.
Like how both players are nicely color coordinated. Ronda in the blue and black. Carla in the, is that purple or fuchsia?
That would be fuchsia.
That's fuchsia. And black. I can ask you that because you're the clothing guy, right?
I am. I like how Carla's matching the shirt to the shoes. It's a nice touch.
Yeah, it is very nice. Ronda doing the same with blue.
True.
Nice backhand by Carla. Earns another point. And she's out to a quick 5-2 lead. I guess not quick, but she's out to a 5-2 lead.
Yeah, Carla's an aggressive player, so I think she's always kind of someone that comes out hot and, you know, shooting every ball. So I think it's not surprising that she's going out to an early leading match like this. You know, Ronda's kind of a cerebral player. She's going to work her way into a match. So I don't think a 5-2 lead is going to concern her very much.
Is that a nice way to say slow starter? Is that what you were trying
to say? Slow starter.
Okay. It sounded a lot more diplomatic than that, right?
Yeah, no, definitely a slow starter.
No,
I also think in a match like this where the we'll call it the underdog playing the favorite, you know, typically the underdog comes out with nothing to lose, shooting every ball. So,
right.
You know, definitely not a surprising start to this game, but, you know, it's what we're going to have to see is how long can...
Oh, what a great get by Ronda.
You know, how long can Carla keep this up?
Right.
You know, and she has the early lead, so even if Ronda starts to catch up, you know, Carla just needs to keep the same distance she has.
Well, right. She needs to do that, and she needs to be wary of the fact that at some point in time, Ronda's going to put the car into another gear.
Correct. Which that last dive may have kind of done for her.
Yeah. Serving here at 3-6. Oopsie.
Yeah.
Sidewall first.
Yeah, she didn't have much room to fit that serve in.
Nope. Not at all. Carla now serving a 6-3. Good hands by Rasich in the middle of the floor. I see a timeout coming. Rhonda taking a timeout. The players are on a 45-second break. We're going to do the same. We'll be right back here on LPRT Live.
After that quick break, Rhonda in the box. Duffs that one off her racket a little bit there.
Six serving three. That was loud.
Antonio and Carlos are on eight.
Yeah, apparently so.
For those of you at home.
Yeah, that's if you didn't hear it the first time.
Yeah. Great serve by Rhonda.
Yep.
This is kind of a funky right side wall. It's glass. It's got some metal at the bottom. So.
Yeah, it is a little weird, right? It's got concrete in the middle. Well, actually, the panel's in the middle. So the glass is actually split in half.
Yeah.
So yeah, that wall can take some weird bounces.
Yeah, so I think the players are going to be using that to their advantage throughout the week.
Oh, big skip by Carla off the back. Now five serving six.
Kind of like what we talked about. You know, Carla, I think, was up 6-1, 6-2, and she's still playing aggressive but not making the same shot she was making before. And now Rhonda has, you know, slowly and kind of, you know, not so flashy, you know, not so flashy
right.
way, worked her way back into this.
Yep.
Now she's just making shots, scoring points little by little.
Six serving six, all tied up here in game one. Skip ball by Carla gives Rhonda her first lead of this match. It's 7-6 in game one. Great get by Carla.
Not going to get that one.
Easy put away for Rhonda, but great hustle on Carla's part.
Yeah.
And Carla taking a timeout at 8-6. We're on another 45-second break. We are going to be right back here on LPRT Live.
Improve your level of play. Choose Fran Davis Racquetball for dynamic camps and instructional DVD.
I strongly recommend Fran Davis if you're serious about improving your level of play.
She really is the best instructor that I've ever seen in the game of racquetball.
This lady knows how to win, knows how to create winners. Believe me.
Improve your game today by visiting FranDavisRacquetball.com.
Back towards the court here.
What was that? Oh, it does. Look at that. Carla's water bottle matches her outfit. Wow. 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 You guys can't see this at home, but we were talking about the players with their coordinated outfits. Carla's water bottle matches her shirt. So she has gone all in on this matching thing.
It's a Great shot.
I think it's fuchsia was what I was told by the clothing guy.
Great shot by Carla.
Yeah. Oh, great serve by Carla. Going to get a big setup off the back glass. There pinches that left corner. That's a great rally for Carla.
Yep. I think, you know, she went up 6-1. You know, they got tied 6-6. Now she's down 8-6. I think it would be, you know, mentally very important for her to score this point and tie it back up at 8-8.
Yep. Goes back to that same serve.
There she is.
There you go. Another three-shot rally and a baby fist pump.
Yep. And I think that fist pump was her realizing how important that point was.
All tied up, 8-8. Nice shot by Rhonda. Back in the box.
Good scrambling rally for Carla there, but a great put away by Rhonda to win it.
9-8. 9 serving 8.
It's a great serve.
That ball is going to stay down. Yeah, Carla was looking for the short serve call.
Yeah, it was a good serve.
Yeah, it was pretty close. I didn't see it bad, so I can't call it bad.
You know, now's not the time for her to get fixated on one short serve call.
Right. First,
she needs to side out here.
Yep, first game point opportunity here for Rasic in game one. And there it is, game one to Rhonda Rasic, 11-8. We are on a 90-second break. We're going to be right back here on LPRT Live.
Just you and I.
Carlos Irving first, 0-0. Rondo looking for the hinder, and referee's going to call two bounces. Rondo deciding if she's going to say anything about it, and does decide to tell the referee that it was a hinder, and it's still a point, 1-0.
Yeah, but I think that was... Wasn't it? She has a short serve.
You were going to ask a question.
No, I thought Carla started the game with an ace. I think that she did call that a...
No, she called that a two-bounce get on Rhonda when Rhonda wanted the hinder. Now, Carla may have started with an ace, but Rhonda with the big ball up front. Oh, big swing and a miss.
There's that glass.
Yep, too close to that glass wall. Now it's 2-0, so I guess not. Yeah, that was really close to that sidewall glass. Oh, nice get by Carla. Not going to get that one, but great effort.
Carla's getting to a lot of balls. I mean, she always does, but she's... I like her body language in this match.
Yep.
She's playing very confidently. She's not winning every rally, but she's going for every ball. She's not getting down on herself at all.
No. I mean, she was right there in the first game, right? 11-8, and she had a big lead, big lead early. She was right in that first game, so no reason at all for her to get down on herself. So there.
I think she's also, isn't she typically a player who plays Rhonda tough? I know she's
she
never
does.
Beaten her, but I feel like she's always sort of in the match.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree.
It's one of those styles that maybe just doesn't match up with Rhonda's game well.
Yep. Yeah, maybe so. I never have Rhonda looking for the short serve. Probably not getting that call.
It was a good serve, too.
And doesn't need it as she pinches the backhand to win the rally.
Yep.
That was nice.
Great backhand by Rhonda.
Yep. Yeah, very nice shot. One serving two now. Great get by Carla. Stayed with it, got really low. She was almost sitting on her heels.
Yeah.
First game next door went to Veronica Sotomayor. She took game one over Michelle Key. I think it was like 11-8.
11-8, and now it looks like Michelle is up 6-1. But Michelle was up 7-1, I believe, in the first game.
Oh, good hustle by Carla. Just not quite able to get there. Nice pinch for Rhonda off that back glass. One serving two here in game number two. Nice pass from Carla down that left side. That sounds like the coach's job. Short serve called by referee Monsi Mejia.
Hey, keep one on deck. I'll be ready. Short.
Second serve coming from Carla Munoz. Half lob Z to the right side. Rhonda with the overhead. Leaves herself wide open and way out of position. Carly easily pinches that right corner. Who do you know in Memphis, Tennessee? Want me to answer it for you? Jonathan Clay's phone. big forehand by Rhonda. Two serve and three. Short serve.
Short.
Half lob to the right side. Rhonda trying to use that wall. Kicks that sidewall glass. Big setup for Carla.
That was actually not as easy a shot as she made it look. Took kind of a funky bounce off that weird wall. She's staring into the glass and just flat rolled that forehand. That was a tougher shot than it seemed like.
It looked really easy.
It's because these are professionals, Andy.
That's what it is. Skip ball by Rasich.
I like that shot, too, by Carla. You know, I was just starting to think, it seems like she's relying on the sidewall to win a lot of her points.
Mm-hmm.
And I like that last shot where she just hit a nice, hard, straight angle right at Rhonda to handcuff her. You know, and it's not trying to rely on those corners so much. See, like that. Like that. She wins a lot of points that way, but that's a dangerous way to, I think, win a match. You know, and I think winning points that way is what equals losing 11-8 games.
Yeah, maybe so. If she misses three of them, yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, it's one of those things where if you're not using a line, see right there, she went for a line and missed
right.
it. You know, if you're not using your lines right and you're relying on the sidewalls, they have to be perfect.
Oh, no doubt.
And they have to be perfect for an entire game, and that's super hard.
No question. It absolutely is.
See, there's another. She went for another line and, you know, left that ball up.
Yep. Yep, nice finish by Rasich. Earns a point. We're now at 3-5. Skip ball by Carla. Another point for Rhonda. 4-5.
And every point she's lost here has been on a straight shot.
So then she should go back to hitting the pinches that you just told her was a bad idea. Because no. She makes those.
Well, no, she needs to make the lines need to become more effective.
Oh.
See, there's another one. She goes line and loses the point.
Oh, so going back to the pinch where you can actually win a rally is a bad idea?
We got a timeout here by Carla.
Players are on a break. We're going to be right back here on LPRT Live. All right, we're back here at the 2015 24th Annual NES Associates Christmas Classic Pro-Am. We need to have a limit on how long a tournament name can be. It's a lot.
Listen, if the sponsor's got a long name, we love them.
Sponsor's name is actually relatively short, NES Associates.
That's true. There is a lot of other stuff.
Yeah. Camera.
Five
serving five. Tied up here in game number two. Skip ball by Rasich. Carla switching up a little bit, away from the drive serve to that half lob to the right side.
Ouch.
You know, I have this huge urge to say something right now, don't you? She won that rally pinching that left corner.
Well, yeah, no, I
have a huge urge to say something about
I'm
that right
I'm
now.
I'm okay with that, and if she can win an entire game shooting those pinches, I'm cool with it. But I don't think it's really possible to win an entire game on one shot. See, there you go. Just lost that rally hitting a pinch, so where's your argument there?
All right, so she's lost one rally hitting the pinch and about four rallies trying to hit the ball straight in.
It's about creating. I think she what she needs to do is have more consistency on all of her shots.
I would agree.
You know, she needs to be able to win points more than one way.
No, I agree with you.
Because you can't rely on the sidewall for everything.
Nope, I totally agree.
Yeah.
Still sticking with that half lob, the half lob Z to Rhonda's forehand, and even though Rhonda got a setup, she can't put it away.
Yeah.
So I'm not crazy about the choice to serve, but she's earned a point or two with it.
Yeah. I think a lot of it might be the glass. But, I mean, Rhonda's been playing on this court for a number of years, so. There's another weak return and a point. So maybe she's found a serve here.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe she's found a shot she can win a rally with.
Got three more points to go.
Eight serve and five. Same serve again. Rhonda going to step up, cut it off. Nice rally from Carla.
Yep.
9-5 here in game two. There we go. Nice cut. Nice short hop from Rhonda on the forehand side.
Super important, I think, for Carla to have a quick side out here.
Oh, I agree.
She's got a lot of momentum. You know, I think if she lets Rhonda run off 2 points here, this game's going to get out of hand. That's what she needs to do.
Yep.
And probably close this game out right here.
No, I agree. You do not want to let Rhonda hang around in the game.
Yeah, any top player. I mean, if you have a 9-5 lead on any top player, you know, and you're the underdog, which Carla is in this scenario, you know, you need to close out when you get the opportunity. Like, right there's an opportunity. And she took it. That's what she needs to do.
Yeah,
That shot right there, she had to win that point.
Yep. Yeah.
Any opportunity she gets in a tight spot like this, she has to capitalize right then.
Sticking with the same serve. Rhonda going to cut it off again. Great save by Races. That's going to be a tough ball for Carla.
Is it set up?
Trading ceiling balls. There it is. Goes to that corner. Gets another setup out of it. And the cross-court pass. Winner for Carla Munoz, 11-5. Players are on a 90-second break, and we're going to be right back as well. We are here in Arlington, Virginia on LPRT Live.
You don't have to be the best to be trained by the best. Fran Davis coaches racquetball's greatest professional players. Fran Davis wants to train you. No matter what level of play you are, Fran Davis Racquetball is a proven system to help you win on the court. Check out her book, her DVD, her iPhone and iPad apps, or work with her in person to build your own racquetball dream house. Check her out online at FranDavisRacquetball.com.
Right, we're back here for the start of game three. We are one game apiece. Rhonda serving first here to start game three.
Just short.
Nice nickel. Wow. Pretty aggressive return by Carla.
Yeah, I like that. I like the way she's starting this game. You know, she's obviously coming off of a big win in the second. She was close in the first, so she obviously knows she's right in the middle of this match. You know, I think it's this third game is huge, huge right now for Carla. You know, I don't think Carla wins this match in five. I think if she's going to win it, she wins it in four.
I think she could win it at five, but I don't think she wins it if she goes down
right,
2-1.
Right. True.
She has to be ahead. She has to be ahead 2-1 going into the fourth in order to win in five.
Yeah, so she needs to come out aggressive and swinging in this third game, and I
agree.
Like that.
I agree.
I'm also a big believer in it's one of those things where if you're
what do you think? Rhonda and four from Frederick Lombard. Oh, wait, you were muted. Hold on. What do you think?
I think Rhonda went for it. But I think that Carla is actually playing pretty good, and her shoes matching with her shirt is helping her a lot.
Oh, did you notice that her shoes also match her water bottle?
I have not noticed, so that's probably why she's playing good.
Could be. Three serving zero. Nice cross court backhand from Rhonda, left to right.
You know, going back to that talk about, you know, aggressive play from Carla, I also think when you are the underdog, I know we keep saying that, obviously, even though Carla's playing fantastic, on paper, we're calling it the underdog.
Right.
You know, I don't think you pull off an upset playing passively.
No, I agree.
I think you need to play aggressive to upset a player.
No question. You know, I absolutely agree.
And being that Carla has an aggressive style, I think it works to her advantage, and she's playing confidently.
No, I agree. I agree. She does she absolutely needs to stay aggressive the entire match.
Yeah.
Rhonda's not going to give her a match.
Yeah, and I think if I'm Carla, I'm okay losing swinging.
Oh, no question.
You know, I'm not okay losing playing passively, going to the ceiling, you know, conserving. If I'm going down swinging,
right,
I'll take that.
I agree. I would rather skip the last point versus having my opponent hit a winner.
Right.
There's no doubt.
Now, that doesn't mean play careless. You know,
there's
a fine line between aggressive and careless. But I don't think, you know, that's a wow. You know, Carla's definitely not playing careless at all. She's playing in a very controlled, aggressive manner right now.
Going to get a big setup off the back glass. Great get by Rasich.
She's going to get
that
too.
Leaves the ball up. Oh,
wow.
My. What a great rally.
Yeah. Carla's really, really playing well this match.
Yep. Yeah, I know she's been working real hard back home.
It's showing. So
it absolutely is.
And I don't get to see her play too often, obviously, but this is, to me, some of the best ball I've seen her play.
Looking for the two bounce get.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that one.
Yeah. I thought Rhonda got the ball, and Carla put the next one away, so
it
doesn't really matter.
My initial thought was she might not have gotten it, but, you know, Carla played through it and won the point. Carla, she's on every ball. I love that. Even that last shot, which was a really good pass by Rhonda. And obviously, Carla didn't get it, but she is right on that ball.
Yep. I think Rhonda's taking a timeout, so we're gonna take our own little timeout, and we'll be right back here on LPRT Live.
Improve your level of play. Choose Fran Davis Racquetball for dynamic camps and instructional DVD.
I strongly recommend Fran Davis if you're serious about improving your level of play.
She really is the best instructor that I've ever seen in the game of racquetball.
This lady knows how to win, knows how to create winners. Believe me.
Improve your game today by visiting FranDavisRacquetball.com.
Rhonda, in the middle of that timeout, was kind of looking for some rules clarifications. She's feeling some tight play out there right now.
And hits a short serve. Yeah, the question, just so that you folks know at home, is she asked whether or not she was entitled to finish her shot. By finishing her shot, she meant, what she meant is she entitled to a follow-through? And what she was saying to me was that she is shortening her follow-through because Carla is playing close. And she's asking whether or not she's actually allowed to follow all the way through. Right? My response to her was, if you hit Carla with your racket on the follow-through, it is not a hinder, which is the rule. It's not a hinder. So I don't know if technically you are allowed or not allowed your follow-through, but what I do know is that if you hit her, you cannot be, you do not get rewarded for that. Does that make sense?
Okay. Got it.
So I don't know that that specifically answers your question, but I don't know that there is an answer to the question, am I entitled to finish the shot?
I think it's probably situational more than anything else, because I would almost think your follow-through is part of your shot. So if you're not able to shoot the ball, I would think that would absolutely be a hinder.
Well, except for the fact that if you hit somebody with a follow-through, it's not a hinder.
Okay, I did not know that.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, because technically, by rule, once the ball leaves your racket, that's it's now no longer your shot.
Got it.
So that's a little tricky, so.
Rhonda going for a lot of shot right there. Trying to tie this up.
Rhonda looking for the hinder, doesn't get the call, but rolls out, but hits a winner with the pinch. So now that one, since she hit her with her backswing, that is a hinder,
right?
What's going on with you? So she's up 2-0? All right, on the next court over, Veronica Sotomayor up 2-0 over Michelle Key. Great get by Rasich. Wow. And a nice winner from Rhonda. Ball by Carla.
No.
Score's 8-4 here for Racic in game number three. So round out to a big lead here in the third game. Carla taking a timeout. And we're going to do the same. We're going to be right back.
For Rhonda after that timeout.
Good hold by Rhonda. Trying to be aggressive with that half lob. Half lob Z. Carla might need to get a little more angle on that to get it away from herself.
Yep.
Straight lob down the right side. That's going to be a tough one. Going for the corner and finally misses one.
Yep.
Eight serving four. Shot by Rhonda down the left side, earns another point.
9-4.
At 9-4 now.
Steve Norquist, Jerry Belmonte.
Nine serving four. Short serve.
On the court next to us, Veronica Sotomayor is up 2-0 and 3-0 in the third game against Michelle Key.
Yeah, that's a tough early round match for Michelle, you know.
Yeah.
Veronica's
for
one of the
really for both of them.
Well, it is. I mean, my point to that is, you know, Veronica is one of our, you know, part-time players on tour, and, you know, if she were playing full-time, I think her ranking would be a lot higher, and these two probably wouldn't, they probably wouldn't see each other this early in the draw.
Right.
Good save by Racic into the back glass. And a winner by Rhonda on the re-kill. 9-5.
Rhonda seems to be in pretty good control this match right now.
Yep.
Well, that's a nice shot by
Carl. That was a nice shot. That ball had a lot of spin on it, too. It was
tricky
serve. It was not coming off of there very clean.
Yeah.
Thank you. I think you do. Towel timeout to clean up a little bit of the floor. So, we're going to have a big crowd here this weekend at the Christmas Classic. 174, 175 in the draw.
Yep, biggest ever.
Biggest ever. Last year at this club.
Yep.
So, I think there were some, you know, some sentimental players coming out for, you know, one last hurrah at the Sport and Health here in Crystal City.
Yeah, because, I mean, this is what, the 24th?
24th annual event, yeah.
Yeah, so this has been a long time here.
And I don't know that it's been in this location for all 24 years, but it's been here for a long time.
Yeah, it's a really cool club. It's a cool community for racquetball. Seems like a very close-knit community of players. I love coming down here. The club's fun. You know, as we mentioned, it's the final time here, but what you might not know at home is the club's closed.
Yeah.
So we're the only people in the building.
Yeah, the club closed last weekend.
Yeah, they reopened just for this tournament.
Right.
So there's no one on the machines. There's no one anywhere else. There's no staff. It's just us.
Yeah, exactly.
It's kind of a cool, cool atmosphere for a tournament.
Oh, my God.
All right. Rhonda serving, I think the score is 9-5.
Yep.
Short serve. Oh, nice crack out of that right side wall.
Yeah, Carla kind of overran that ball a little bit.
Yep. First game point opportunity here in game three for Racich. Short serve. Good get by Rhonda. Keep the ball in play. Carla going to have to go back up top. It's going to be a big setup off the back for Rhonda. Pinches the ball. Leaves it up. Carla puts it away straight in. Five, serve, and 10. Six, serving, 10. Oh, that was tough. Carla needed a ladder and couldn't get there. Second game point opportunity here for Racich. And there it is, game three to Rhonda Racich, 11-6. Players are going to take a 90-second break. We're going to do the same. We're going to be right back here on LPRT Live.
All I need is your hand. In your heart, let's be free, run away from it all. Just you and I. Just you and I. Here we are, face to face. Nobody watching, we're alone, alone, alone. Take all of your worries, let them go, let them go. I'll bring you to stars. Reconnite from the world if we want. Just you and I.
Hey, we're back. Back here for the start of game four. Rhonda up 2-1.
We kind of said last match that we thought if Carla lost that third that she probably would lose in four, so we'll see what happens
well,
here.
Well, I didn't say she'd probably lose in four. I said I don't think she could win in five.
That's
if she's
yes,
down
true.
2-1.
There you go.
I don't think she's going to win two in a row.
Correct.
She gets the first serve here in here in the fourth game, so we'll see.
Yeah, she came out.
See how she comes out.
Came out super strong in the third game, but wasn't really able to sustain it. You know, I think she needs to do that again now, but also sustain it, because I also don't think she wants to be playing from behind down a game.
Oh no, absolutely not. You don't want to do that. Yeah, almost sounded like Rhonda fouled that one off.
Yep.
Fouled that one off the frame of the racket, but it turned out to be a pretty good shot. That one, I think, is over, and if I'm right, I got to go back to work, so I leave this to you for a minute.
All right. Andy's going back to work because Veronica Sotomayor has beat Michelle Key in three. Carla's going to want an avoidable on that, but she definitely went the wrong way. I think that's a good call.
Yeah, I didn't see it, so... That's a good call by the referee. That ball skipped in. That one I saw.
Wow. Great shot.
And another skip ball by Carla. You have two new grocery coupon notifications.
Sweet. Good shot by Carla.
Lob serve down the right side. That kicks off into the middle floor. Easy return for Rasich. Not so easy return for Carla.
Just
short serve called. Yep. Good call by the referee. Rhonda looking for a towel to clean up the court. scores 4-0 here in the fourth game. Rhonda serving 4-0. Drive serve left. Carla down that line. Ooh, that was going to be a tough ball for Rhonda to pick off. That's an easy shot for Rhonda to make.
Yeah, Rhonda seems to be in control here.
Yeah, no doubt. Carly is not playing as well as she was playing earlier in the match.
No.
But, you know, we talked about that. You know, it's hard to play, you know, play at that high of a level for the whole match.
Correct.
Skip ball by Carla on that pinch that she hasn't missed in a long time, and she takes the timeout. So the players are on a break, and we're gonna do the same. We're going to be right back here on LPRT Live.
Improve your level of play. Choose Fran Davis Racquetball for dynamic camps and instructional DVD.
I strongly recommend Fran Davis if you're serious about improving your level of play.
She really is the best instructor that I've ever seen in the game of racquetball.
This lady knows how to win, knows how to create winners. Believe me.
Improve your game today by visiting FranDavisRacquetball.com.
Coming back on the court.
Yep. Down 5-0 here in the fourth game.
Yep.
So not a good place for her to be if she's down 2-1.
No.
Short serve called. Ball. Now 6-0. Quickly getting away from Carla.
And Ron is just little by little just adding points.
And that's Carla, a nice shot. Good call. And a hinder call by referee Monty Mejia. Second serve. No, first serve is 0-6. Thank you. All right.
Another point for Rhonda. Just keep adding them.
Yep, just grinding them away here now, 7-0. And Carla hits it right back to her, but she's going to get another setup. And Rhonda's right there. Good read by Rasich. That's going to be tough. Oh, and a big skip by Rhonda out of the back. Hi there, Cindy Tilbury, out in sunny Southern California. Jonathan and I are jealous. We're here in relatively cooler Arlington, Virginia.
Yeah, I'd rather be in the Hollywood Hills myself.
Yeah, well, actually Malibu, right?
Isn't that the Hollywood Hills?
No.
No?
No, Malibu's different than the Hollywood Hills.
Oh.
Hollywood Hills are where the big Hollywood sign is.
I'll go to either one. I don't care.
All right.
I'm not picky.
Timeout by Carla. Players want a break. We're going to be right back. All right, we're back. Game number four, Rhonda serving at 8-0. Zero serving nine.
Is that live, right? Automatically live?
Hmm?
No one's that can watch it.
Yeah.
Hang on, man.
Skip ball by Carla. 10 serving one here. Match point opportunity number one for Rasich. And not going to get it on that one. I'm sorry, 1-9. Sorry, not match point opportunity. No, 1-9. Skip ball by Rasich. Good call by the referee. Two serving nine now. That's not right. Nine serving two now. Yeah.
could just take the dot com off on the last board.
Oh my, that was an uncomfortable looking dive. Yeah, I wouldn't know. I haven't dove for a ball since 1988. First match point opportunity here for Rasich, 10 serve and 2. Coming up next on this court when this match is over is the Battle of the Marias. Maria Jose Vargas versus Maria Renee Rodriguez.
Fun.
That ball was not where Rhonda was expecting it at
no.
all. Not sure that was actually where Carla was expecting it either. Two serving 10. Nice shot by Carla. Earns another point. 3-10. She's got a long way to go to come back here in this fourth game, though. Rhonda looking for the hinders, going to get the call. Yeah, that's a good call by the referee. If Rhonda comes up and tries to cut that ball, tries to cut that serve off, she's just going to whack Carla in the back of the head.
With what?
I'm not sure if she's going to hit her with the ball or the racket, but it looks like she's going to whack her with
before
something.
Before, you said if she hits her with the racket, it's not a hinder. Because it would be on her follow-through.
Right, correct.
So then shouldn't she have to take that ball? By your definition?
I think the referee's calling a safety hinder.
Got it.
Because it's before the ball struck, not after the ball struck.
Got it.
Wow. Three serving 10. Rhonda cracks that ball out of the right side wall, gets back in the box for another match point opportunity here at 10-3. There it is, match to Rhonda Rasich. She moves on to the quarterfinals tomorrow morning to play Veronica Sotomayor, I believe. All right, next up on this court, Maria Jose Vargas versus Maria Renee Rodriguez. We're going to be right back here in about 15 minutes on LPRT Live. You don't need to do that. Well, I guess we can. We need to let it run for about a minute. Let's be free, run away from it all. Just you and I. Just you and I. Just you.
you and I.